everybody, it's Jim here. Today we're going to make a dish that everybody loves. We're going to make some fresh hot pizza. Only our pizza is going to be a little bit different. We're not going to use the dairy, we're not going to use the cheese, we're not even going to use any grains. This is going to be cauliflower based crust with veggie toppings and vegan cheese. So let's get started. Here's the ingredients that go into the crust. Of course, we're going to have one medium head of cauliflower, and I'll show you how to prepare that in a minute. We're going to make one chia egg, and I'll show you how to do that. We're going to take some vegan gourmet mozzarella cheese. We're going to shred that up. We're going to have a quarter cup of Go Veggie Parmesan cheese, and that also is vegan. A half a teaspoon of dried oregano, half a teaspoon of dried basil, half a teaspoon of garlic powder, half a teaspoon of crushed red pepper. What did I leave out here? That's the onion salt. 3 tablespoons of coconut flour. And lastly, 4 teaspoons of xanthan gum. That's kind of like a binder. So let's get started. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to wash and prepare our cauliflower. Okay, I've washed and dried our cauliflower. Now what we need to do is to get rid of the stem. We don't want to use that. And the best way to do that, I think, is just to slice the cauliflower in half. That will kind of expose all the stem. Then take a smaller knife and just get in there. You want to get as much of the stem out as possible. The stem is certainly good to eat, but in this recipe, we want to keep it to a minimum. Go ahead and put this in a bowl. I have a little nut chopper that I used for this recipe. I used to do it in my Vitamix, but I found out that the nut chopper works just as well and does a pretty good job. So I'm going to show you how to do it using one of these little chopping devices. Here we go right here, and these are available in any cooking store will have them, and it's a nice little handy gadget to have around. What you want to do is just go ahead and fill it up with the cauliflower, give it 5 or 6 hits, and there you have it. You've riced up the cauliflower. Let's do another batch, get one more in there. About 5 is what I usually hit it with. What you want to do is you want to kind of rice this cauliflower up a little bit. You want small pieces without stem. Here's a pan. Let's go ahead and do the rest of this. And now we can put this back in the bowl. So that's what our cauliflower should look like. It's got the consistency of, I guess rice would be a good way to describe it. So we're going to take this, we're going to pop it into the microwave and cook the cauliflower. So okay, while that cauliflower is cooking, we're going to go ahead and prepare our chia egg. So what I've got is I've got 1 teaspoon of white chia seeds. I'm going to add 3 tablespoons of water to that, and then we're going to let this sit for about 5 minutes or so, and it will become kind of an egg-white consistency. And this is used primarily as a binder, very much like you would use an egg as a binder. Now we need also to prepare our oven, so we're going to get our oven going. We're going to get it going at 450 degrees. There we are, 450, and we'll let that preheat. If you have a pizza stone, you want to go ahead and put that in the oven to preheat as well. That'll help quite a bit to help cook the bottom of the cauliflower crust. Okay, we've taken our cauliflower and I put it in the microwave for 8 minutes to let it cook. I didn't add anything to it. Just put in your crumbles into the microwave, 8 minutes, and you're done. So now another thing we can prep for is our parchment paper. And I like to take a sheet of parchment around the same size as my pizza stone, and going to put that out on our cutting board here. And we want to spray that down very lightly with some spray oil. Not much, just a little bit. Okay, our cauliflower has cooked. I put it in this larger bowl to help it cool down. What we're going to do now is we're going to take a nut milk bag, which you can get in any of the cooking stores, and we'll take a measuring cup here, and we want 3 cups of cooked cauliflower. 3 cups. Now I do a cup at a time. What we're going to do is place that in the nut bag, and then what we're going to do is drain the water out of this cauliflower. You'll get a lot of water. Look at all that water you get out of there. And the reason you want to do this is this will give your crust more of a crust kind of texture rather than more of a texture of like a mushy kind of a crust. So get as much water out as you can. And you'll see this will shrink down a little bit the more water you get out of it. That's okay. The end result is you want to wind up with about 2 cups of cauliflower dough, I guess we could call it. So let's go ahead and pour this dough, and you can see it kind of almost looks like a dough once you've got the water out of it. Still. And now we're ready for the next step. We're going to take our dried cauliflower, we're going to mix in the rest of our ingredients, the mixed spices, the coconut flour, get everything in there. We're going to add the chia egg, which is now a nice consistency, almost like an egg white. Put that all in there. And finally, we're going to add 1/4 cup of the vegan Go Veggie Parmesan cheese. Get that all in there. And now it's a matter of mixing it all up into a dough. Now there's a lot of ways to do this, but to be quite honest, I find the best way is just to get in there with your hands. So let me go ahead and mix this dough up. Get it nice and mixed. Get everything mixed together. Okay, I've mixed up all of our dough. Now it's time to take that parchment paper, put it back on our cutting board, and now we're going to take this dough and just put it out onto our board. That's the best way, I think. It gets it all out there. And you can see it has the consistency of a dough. So what we want to do now is press it out into a crust, and you can make it, however you like it. I like to make it look like pizza, so I make it in a round, but you can make a square crust or whatever you'd like. And you want to press it out pretty thinly. You don't want to get it too thin, but you don't want to leave it too thick either. So that's you'll have to make it a couple of times and find out what works best for you. There we are. We're just about done. And I like to bring the edges up a little bit so that you can hold the ingredients, your toppings, a little bit better in your sauce once this crust is cooked up. So, okay, now we've got our pizza crust, and I formed it to about the same size as my pizza pan, my pizza stone. So I'm going to take my stone out now. Actually, I'm not going to take it all the way out. I just want to bring it out enough to where I can take my heated stone, and we're going to take this pizza crust on the parchment paper. I usually use the cutting board, and just slide it onto my heated pizza stone. And then we're going to go ahead and put that back in the oven. Oops, forgot one thing. We do want to spray this very lightly. Spray the top of your crust just lightly with a little bit of oil. And now we're going to pop it in the oven. We're going to let this cook at 450 for about 20 minutes or so. Okay, while our crust is cooking up, I've decided what I want to use for toppings. And today I feel a little adventurous, so instead of using pizza sauce, I'm going to try something new. I'm going to try a mild salsa, and let's see how that tastes. I think it should be good. So I got my mild salsa instead of my pizza sauce. You can use pizza sauce if you like. I've got some fresh basil. It doesn't get any fresher than this. This was out in my yard growing about 20 minutes ago, so can't get any fresher than fresh basil that way. I've got some little cherry tomatoes that I've chopped up in half. And we had some peppers in the refrigerator, so I'm going to use those up. And that's my toppings. The vegan mozzarella cheese, we're going to shred that on top. And as soon as our crust is ready, we'll go ahead and bring it out and we'll make our pizza. Now you could pick whatever kind of toppings you like. So if you like mushrooms, go ahead and put some mushrooms on. If you want to make a Hawaiian pizza, you can use some vegan pepperoni and in replace of the ham, some pineapple chunks. Use your imagination. You know what you like on your pizza, so go for it. This is the time to be creative. I think our crust is done, so let's check our oven and see how we did. Yeah, that's just about what I want. And we'll put that on the cutting board here. Just off the cutting board, and you can see it's got kind of a look of a pizza crust. You want it a little bit brown around the edges, and it's nice and firm. So now we're going to go ahead and put our toppings on. But before we do that, we want to do one more thing with the oven. We want to put the oven now to broil on high. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this crust once we top it, and we're going to pop it back into the oven to warm up the top. Okay, first we'll put on our sauce, and I want to get a fair amount of this on there. I'm going to try to limit the amount of liquid in the salsa, because I really don't want this to be too wet. Never had it with salsa before, so like I said, you could use just regular old pizza sauce, salt-free, of course. In this case, I saw this and I said, you know, I feel adventurous. Let's go ahead and do it. And that's the way cooking should be. Play with your food. Try different things. It's a lot of fun. It really is. All right, let's get some of this fresh basil on there. Oh, yeah, that looks nice. This is a great pie to make during the holiday season because you've got the Christmas colors, the green and the red from the tomatoes. And that looks like that's enough of basil. Get some tomatoes on there. I like tomatoes, so we'll load those up pretty good. And like I say, any ingredients that you like, just go ahead and put it on there. Feel free to do whatever you'd like. It's starting to look good already. Okay, and lastly, a couple of pepper flakes. And there we have it. Last thing we need to do now is go ahead and put our cheese on. So I got my grater here. We're just going to grate some of this mozzarella cheese right on the top. Of course, this is vegan cheese, so there's no dairy at all. And there we have it. So we're ready to go ahead and get this thing in the oven. Looks great, doesn't it? Okay, now let's get it back in the oven. Our oven is set on broil, and it is on high. So let's go ahead and pop the pizza back in. And we're going to let it stay in there for, oh, I don't know, 2-3 minutes. Not very long, just enough to get our cheese to melt. And of course, we're still on our parchment paper as well. All right, let's set our timer, 3 minutes. Okay, there's our timer. So our pizza's coming out of the broiler now. Let's see how we did. Oh, yeah. That looks beautiful. Let me see if I can get it up there for you. Doesn't that look great? about the longest 2 minutes you'll ever spend, but you do need to let this cool a little bit. Okay, here goes a taste with the salsa instead of the pizza sauce. Let's see how it is. Wow. That's pretty good. I use mild salsa. I don't think I would recommend hot unless you really want to kick it up a couple of notches. Because, like Emerald would say, bam! This kicked it up a notch. This Jim saying so long for now. It's pretty good pizza.